Hey everyone, welcome you all. I am Porselvan. In this video, we are going to see about the skills to be developed for the ECE students. We have previously posted the same type of video for the CS students. If you are interested, you can check it by pressing the link at the description. And let me divide this video into three sections. The first section is about the job options provided for the ECE students, and the second section is about the skills to be developed, and the third section is about the salary range provided for the ECE students. Now, without any delay, let's get started. Now let us look at the job options provided for the ECE students first. Usually ECE students have a certain advantage on going into the core sector. CS students have to only choose the software field, but ECE students have a choice to choose whether they have to go to IT sector or into the core field. If you are interested in going into the IT field, then you can watch the previous video which I was posted. I have briefly explained about the skills to be developed for the student to get into the IT field. If you are interested in getting into the core sector, then you have to watch this video till the end, because I have spoken about more important information. And let me show you some of the job opportunities provided for the ECE students on the screen now. Let us move on to the second section, that is skills to be developed for the ECE students. The first skill you have to learn is C language. We have to start with C language from your first year, because there is lot to learn about the C language and it will be surely helpful for you on the future. Why I tell you to learn the C language from the first year is because there is lot to learn in it, and it is one of the embedded programming language and it can be used on microcontrollers, and it would be a certain advantage for you while getting into the core field. And the advantage you have if you start from the first year is you can practice a lot in the C language and you can be thorough with the programming language C. So it would be an additional advantage for you guys. And the second important thing you have to learn is about the electronic fundamentals, that is your subject. You should be thorough with the subject which you are going to be read for next 4 years. Just don't stop by learning the electronic fundamentals by just reading. Apply it practically and learn about the applications where it is used. And the third important thing you have to learn about is analog electronics. That is, it is a branch of electronics that deals with continuously variable signals. It is used in radio and audio equipment along with other applications where the signals are derived from analog sensors before being converted into digital sensors. And the fourth thing you have to learn is about the digital electronics, and it is a sub-branch of electronics that deals with the digital signals for processing and controlling various systems and subsystems. There is lot of things to learn about the analog and digital electronics. Make use of internet and books so that you can gain a vast knowledge about these two things. Try to do simple experiments. It will be helping you to understand the concepts very well and in a way. And the fifth thing you have to learn is about the digital communication. Let me tell you about the simple definition of digital communication. Any type of communication using technology is known as digital communication. Example like email, phone calls, video conferencing calls, and many type of SMS and web chat apps like Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp or comes under the digital communication. And the sixth thing you have to learn is about networking. It is a vast subject, and let me tell you some basic things about networking now. Two or more computers that are linked in order to share resources like files and allow electronic communications are known as networking. Networking is essential for the service providers, businessmen and consumers worldwide to share resources and offer services and communicate. There's a lot to learn, as I said earlier. So the most important thing is you should learn for the future. Learning networking will be helping you in the future because it is a vast subject. It is an improving field day by day. So I will be recommending you to learn the networking. And the seventh important thing is start to use Linux OS. Gaining a knowledge about the Linux OS will help you to learn about the networking, testing, embedded systems, database, cloud, Unix, shell scripting and more. Shell scripts are most important thing and it is used everywhere on the daily basis, and learning about the shell scripts will help you to improve your profile and it will play a major role on getting a job at core sector. Now the main important thing is if you have a money to buy a microcontroller, I will be suggesting you to buy a one. Learning to command on the microcontroller using the C language will help you to learn more about the microcontroller, as well as you can mention it on your profile and it would be a certain advantage for you while you are seeking for a job. I think these things will take you 3 years to learn except the C language, because there is lot to learn on C language. You have to learn about the data structures, algorithms and etc. So it will be taking you a lot of time to learn C language. The things which I told other than C language can be learned within 3 years. You should also be thorough with the soft skills, that is like communication, problem solving skills, critical thinking and more. I have mentioned these things on my previous video. If you are interested, you can even check it by clicking the link at the description. Now let us move on to the third section, that is salary. I will be putting some salary range for the freshers and experienced men on my screen. If you have a note and pen, you can note it, or you can even take a screenshot of it. Let me give you some additional tips to get into the core field. First of all, choose the company you want to work at and look at the job positions you are seeking for. Make use of LinkedIn and Indeed to know about the skills to be developed for the specific job position you are looking for, because building the LinkedIn profile will give you more and more number of opportunities. If you want a video regarding how to improve your LinkedIn profile, I will be posting a video on it. You can comment it below. Surely I will be posting it. Finally, it depends on you whether you have to go into the IT sector or core sector. If you are opting to go into the IT field, you will be paid high when compared to core field. The only advantage on the core field is if you gain some experience, you will be paid high on your future and you will be having more practical knowledge. So the decision is yours. You have to choose whether you have to go for IT sector and core sector. I will be providing some links down the below, because it will providing you some idea to choose whether IT or core. And make sure whether you have hit the like button, and please share this content with your friends, because lot of research has been going behind this video and it literally takes me up to 6 hours to edit these videos. And don't forget to subscribe. Let me see you on next one. Thank you.